The recent technological trend that happened in the mobile world technology in the field of hardware is the eSIM. What is eSIM? Electronical SIM? Electrical SIM? Or something other else? So guys, watch this video till the end so you get a clear-cut idea of what eSIM is. Hey guys, I'm Dhanashekaran here and you're watching me on my YouTube channel, Your Tech Bro. So let's get started. Okay, let's keep those things aside. eSIM is also known as the embedded SIM. Yes, from the name you guys might have understood what is embedded SIM. Yes guys, the SIM card that is being embedded inside the smartphone itself from the manufacturer's gate to your house. You can't remove the SIM outside and just move it on with some other devices. So this is completely a pre-built one. So what this eSIM does in your real-time use? It reduces your time and travel and patience and work stress, everything. Like how? Let me explain right now. Previously, if you need a new SIM for your device, you just have to go to the mobile recharge shop. You just have to wait for some time. He'll just give you a credit card size, a palette. From that, you have to break the SIM, eject the SIM, and then insert the SIM. So you need to wait for around 24 hours to just make the SIM being activated on your name. What this time period does is the ID proof that you are being submitted to the mobile recharge shop, he will be just linking your ID proof with the network operator, and the network operator will verify your ID proof, and then he will be just assigning a ID number for you for the particular SIM card so that the SIM is yours. So many of you guys might have a small doubt how to activate the SIM, or else already activated SIM, I just need to just transfer to next operator or else some other operator. So this is really a child's play guys. All you have to do is just download the app that is being provided by the network operator. So there is no such common app. Maybe Airtel network provider will be providing you a different app, and Jio provider will be providing you some other different app to be downloaded. So download the app, a QR code will be there, and some other ID proof linkages will be happening inside the application itself, and a QR code, just scan the QR code and you're good to go. Within 5 to 10 minutes of work, everything is being set up and you can just get to go with your new SIM card. So why is it coming in line with the technology? The reason is it's because reducing the size and increasing the efficiency of a smartphone is the key rule for a success in a manufacturer's point of view. So you guys might have noticed the design wise of just changing aspects in the mobile devices. The previous generation of mobile devices, you'll be just getting at the size of a brick, and right now it's very slim and sleek, and you can just keep your mobile inside your wallet itself. So that much improvement is given in the design wise for a mobile. So these are some of the adjustments to be made so that at the end point of time you just get a very good design of a mobile. So guys, the occurrence of eSIM intensively reduces the size of the smartphone, and there is actually a life proof for this. Like if you're having a SIM ejector tray, so you just eject the tray, you get to go with a couple of SIM cards or else a SD card, else you just get a hybrid SIM slot. So all these storages just makes the device somewhat a little bit bulkier and chunkier. So for this reason, there is no such SIM card tray in the upcoming devices. Like you don't get to go with SIM ejector pin, rather you just get a pre-built SIM that is 15% less than the nano SIM. Right now you guys might have got a really awesome question. Yes, having an eSIM, is it an advantage or a disadvantage for the user? From my point of view, it's certainly an advantage guys. Like the activation and deactivation process all happens right from your desk with a cup of coffee in your hand. Yes, obviously guys, this is a technology wherein you get disadvantages also. For in your phone is not working right now, you can't swap the SIM with other phone. So this is a major disadvantage. I think this can't be negligible from my point of view, but there might be some alternate options for this in future also guys. So guys, currently with Apple iPhone XS and XS Max, you just get this eSIM, and luckily Airtel and Jio has just partnered for this eSIM to be provided with Apple. Actually, this eSIM has not been launched only by Apple with these two devices. This is being launched a couple of years back, or maybe 3 years back, with a flagship device of LG as well as a mid-range mobile of a Samsung. So guys, you just guess it out and do let me know in the comment section below what these two devices are. And that's it for this quick guide on what eSIM does. If you have any more questions regarding this eSIM, do let me know in the comment section below. And guys, if you're ending up liking this video, make sure you hit the thumbs up button below. And if you dislike this video, and hit the dislike button. Thank you for watching this video, guys. Keep updated. Stay tuned. Thanks a lot.